Hello, I'm Andrea Levitt, geriatric care manager and co-owner of Life Transition Resources. Today I plan to share with you information about a variety of community resources that provide services and support for seniors and their families. Whether your loved one lives in their own home or in a long-term care facility, there are available resources for you to consider. First of all, an excellent organization to pursue is the government entity that supports seniors in the county where your loved one resides. In Kansas, you will find it listed as Kansas Department of Aging and Disability Services, or KDADS, K-D-A-D-S, formerly called Area Agency on Aging. Each county in the state has its own agency, so you can search KDADS according to the resident's county. In Missouri, the government resource is called Mid-American Regional Council, or MARC, M-A-R-C. And within their website, they list services by county and also within the Kansas City metro area. Both of these entities are terrific resources that address the broad variety of needs commonly found with aging and disabled people. You will find information about community services involving resources like housing, transportation, in-home care, and how to qualify and receive income-based services. Additionally, they help residents understand Medicare, Medicaid, and other insurance matters, as well as other topics that may interest you. While we are talking about community agencies, I'd also like to introduce you to other organizations that you may find beneficial. There are a number of community centers that provide services for seniors. These may include meals, entertainment, activities, as well as exercise and fitness programs. You'll want to consider Matt Ross Community Center, the Shepherd Center, YMCAs, and the Jewish Community Center. Be sure to also consider what the Johnson County Community College, Kansas City, Kansas Community College, and the University of Missouri, Kansas City, has to offer seniors on the go. Local hospitals commonly have educational and wellness programs offered for seniors. Do consider checking those. Physicians you come in contact with may also have recommendations for support. Ask them and their nurses for ideas. For those seniors who are living in a long-term care community or in need of a variety of services, you may want to know about these two resources. Kansas Advocates for Better Care is an advocacy organization that provides informational support regarding seniors who reside in Kansas. They are knowledgeable about senior issues and happy to provide families with information and resources depending on the concern. Both Kansas and Missouri have long-term care ombudsman programs, whereby volunteer advocates help residents in long-term care facilities maintain or improve their quality of life by ensuring that their rights are not violated. Check to see if your employer is affiliated with an employee assistance program, also known as an EAP. EAPs provide referral information for their employees and can access resources across the country. The EAP may research services. Check to see if your employer is affiliated with an employee assistance program, also known as an EAP. EAPs provide referral information for their employees and can access resources across the country. The EAP may research services for you or already have contacts for services in the community where your family member resides. So, let's talk more specifically about supporting a senior in their own home. Technology is making significant gains in this area. You'll want to consider ways to help to keep your loved ones safe so that they can live as long as they like in the comfort of their own home. Some ideas to consider include a medical alert button that allows them to notify a 24-hour service, which will then contact identified important people who can quickly come to their aid in emergency or non-emergency situations. Your family member may benefit from wearing a bracelet that holds a flash drive that stores critical information for use by emergency personnel should the senior need this type of intervention. Perhaps they would benefit from having a bed alarm, motion detectors, a GPS tracking system, or mats that will notify others if they leave the home. Another simple but highly beneficial appliance is a mechanical pill dispenser that can be set up weekly or biweekly by a family member or nurse. There are a number of home technology companies available to assess and recommend options. Additionally, you would want to include a home safety assessment that could be prescribed by a physician and performed by a home health agency or company specifically geared toward designing adaptive environments. The goal would be to determine ways to modify the senior's home to support them living there safely for as long as possible. Many seniors find that home-delivered meals can be a big help. We've all heard of Meals on Wheels, and this service can be found through the county agencies previously mentioned. However, other private companies are now providing high-quality, diet-specific meals delivered to home. These may be fresh or frozen meals delivered daily or in bulk through the mail. Some companies are local while others are national. Seniors and driving can be an issue of significance. Do you or others have concerns about your parents' driving? Some resources to consider for driving assessment of their ability and safety are AARP, the Rehabilitation Institute of Kansas City, and Shawnee Mission Medical Center's driving program. Adjusting to the aging process can be very difficult for the person experiencing the changes, as well as their family members and caregivers. Be sure to consider support services offered in the community by disease-specific organizations like Alzheimer's or Parkinson's. There are mental health professionals whose practices are specifically geared for seniors and the challenges they face. Several practitioners will even come to the senior's home or facility and provide support to them, billing Medicare for their services. Be sure to also consider religious organizations. Many churches and synagogues, specifically the large ones, have a variety of services aimed to support seniors. Friends and neighbors are also very good referral sources. Ask everyone you know for their ideas and experiences with services that have been helpful. Even folks you don't know, like families you pass in a nursing home or standing in line at the pharmacy. Grocery stores are becoming more senior-friendly, too. Be sure to also consider religious organizations. Many churches and synagogues, specifically the larger ones, have a variety of services aimed to support seniors. Friends and neighbors are also a very good referral source. Ask everyone you know for their ideas and experiences with services that have been helpful. Even folks you don't know, like families you pass at a nursing home or standing in line at the pharmacy. Grocery stores are becoming more senior-friendly, too. Some will deliver groceries for a small fee and even deliver medications prescribed to their pharmacy. Pharmacists are often an overlooked resource. They are very knowledgeable about drug interactions, which pills may be crushed, and have suggestions for less expensive medication options or over-the-counter medications that may benefit the senior. Be sure to get to know your pharmacist. I found them to always be willing to help. Gosh, I know I've told you a lot to consider, perhaps too much. You may be thinking, thanks, Andrea, but where in the world do I start? You may do just fine sorting through the options, finding services, and adjusting the plan as the aging process presents new and different challenges. Or you may want some help from an experienced expert. They will start with an assessment and then work with you to create a plan and priorities. Please consider hiring a geriatric care manager to help you navigate these often turbulent waters experienced by seniors. I think you will be glad you did. Thank you.